This function that describes how the coefficient of friction depends on the wheel slip is a vital part of the simulation. The tricky thing about it is that it stems from experiments. It contains empirical data. We do not have any nice equation for that curve. That is, not until now. One way to deal with such empirical data in the simulation would be to use a lookup table, such as this one. If we input a wheel slip of 0, we output a coefficient of friction that's 0 as well. If we input a wheel slip of 0.1, we output a coefficient of friction that's 0.9, and so on. This would constitute a lookup table. The tricky thing is, what would you do for a wheel slip of, say, 0.01234? What do you do about values of s that are not contained in this column? You have to somehow interpolate these values, which gets complex and is not easy to do in a smooth fashion. A simpler approach is to use a phenomenological equation to guess how one could possibly describe this in mathematics without worrying about the reasons for why it looks the way it looks. We just collect some mathematical functions that produce the right shape. If you look at the shape of this function, you may come up with the following idea. For reasonably large values of s, this function almost is a line. So why not use that line as one component in our equation? And close to zero, it looks as though we are subtracting a quickly decaying function, such as e to the minus 20s. Your job is now to make this work. Pick the right value for the constant a, and then implement this function in Python.